outside gives the people he knows. They don't want service. They want to serve. Because that is what Christ came here to do. He didn't come here to sit and watch the world as it is. He came to serve the world. So continue to fend that fire. Doesn't matter how awkward you sound, when you sound like you have that thing. But anyway, don't feel bad. Don't feel like you're not doing enough. Sometimes we are serving these people. That is what we are sent to do. That is the mandate that God has sent us to. So now we clap hands for these people. Hello, let me clap hands for you. Thank you so much. You can take your seats. Brother pianist. You don't have a drama. I always question God, if you were a woman, you'd be my mother. Allow me to thank my mom. Mama, thank you so much. She took her time to come here. My parents respect my gift so much that they are willing to drop whatever they do.
Oh,
message in Brazil, that one.
Yeah.
Yes, Christ the Redeemer, that's what they call it. From where his house was situated, he could see Christ the Redeemer. So this one day, he's always, let me just explore this Brazil and just see you. But I didn't. So there he is walking and walking, seeing beautiful people, listening to beautiful music. You know, people in Brazil are so beautiful. Yo. So you see this. Flesh. calls us ministration. Why Christ? What's so significant about him? Apart from that, Christ is the Son of God, and he became flesh for us. He possesses 100% DNA of God. No human, no flesh, but he did not have any DNA of either Mary or Joseph. Let me take you to biology 101. You know, I want you to understand this stuff. Yes. So, when Jesus was conceived, the angel of God came upon him and it said to her that you will give birth to the Messiah. Amen. That means, it says Mary was, it's recorded that Mary was a virgin. So she has never slept with any man. So there is no form of a human sperm. Cannot say there's a form of a spiritual sperm. But there is no form of a sperm, of Joseph's sperm in him. That means Jesus did not have the identity of Joseph. And then you'll say, no, then he has the identity of me. He doesn't. You see, when we go through studies, you can Google now. When we go through studies, it says that when a fetus is in its mother's womb, they are connected by something called an umbilical cord. Am I pronouncing it right?
Yes.
Yes. You see, with the umbilical cord, there is no transfusion of blood. Those who did biology, I have like almost a distinction in that, so I think I have the right to say something on this one. But it says that the fetus and the mother only share oxygen and carbon dioxide and nutrients. That's all. Hence, an HIV positive mother can give birth to an HIV negative child. Am I wrong? If I'm wrong, say it so that I just get off this. Alright. So what I'm saying is that Jesus did not have the DNA of Joseph because Joseph's sperm was not in Mary. And he did not have the DNA of Mary because Mary and Jesus shared nothing but oxygen, carbon dioxide, and food. So that makes Jesus 100% God.
The book of Matthew chapter 26 verse 36
38
that said he unto him, my soul is exceeding sorrowful even unto death, tarry ye here and watch with me. And he went a little further and fell on his face and prayed, saying, oh my Father, if it be possible, let this cup pass from me. Nevertheless, not as I will, but as thou wilt.
Amen. So these are almost not the final words, but towards the final words that Jesus said before he died on the cross. I want you to understand. I don't know if God and Jesus had admitted that he became flesh, but he did. And he understood that he came for a mandate. I'm not going to talk to you about how from the age of 12 he knew who he was and going on and healing people, we know that. But I want you to bring it to the last day of Christ. He was on Mount Gethsemane with his disciples when he went and he kneeled down and he hid his face on the ground. You know what he said? I wish this cup may pass me by, but not my will, but your will, God, be done. He understood at that time that his time has come. Remember the prophet Isaiah prophesied that Jesus was coming, and he said, unto you a son is born and a child is given, and the government rests upon his shoulders. The very government, he says, I wish this cup may just pass me by. But it wasn't about him. You can imagine what by 8 heavens. And he called his father. And I can imagine that you said to him, if you are really the son of God, then come down. Can you imagine? Let me tell you something. When I was going through this thing, this joke came to me. I have funny books. It isn't the Bible, like this fight books. You see, you know Elijah, right? Elijah did not die. The chariot came to take him and he went to him. Just like that. So I'm imagining, like Christ being on the cross there. You could have just said, hey, Father, just send Elijah to come, tell him to come and pick me up. I'm sure he's controlling, at least car had petrol. So at that time, he agreed to just be on the cross. He had options. Yeah. He did.
Yeah. Yes.
He had options way before he went to the cross. But because of you, because of you, he saw it fitting that his only begotten son, in all his glory, there is no distinction.
Amen.
We are not